In this video, we will be looking at the ear, nose and throat, cardiovascular, endocrine, dermatological, gastrointestinal, genitourinary and psychiatric systems, and will identify some of the conditions in each system and the impact on our eyes. Conditions and diseases in the specific systems of the human body can impact the eyes, and hence knowing about them and their impact as an eye care practitioner might help you in your assessment of the patient. For other viewers, it will help you to stay alert about your eye health and its relationship with the other systems. So let's look at how the conditions of the ear, nose and throat system can affect the eyes. The nasal passages are situated close to the eyes and have actual connections between each other. And hence, ear, nose and throat conditions do produce certain ocular signs and symptoms. The most common is allergic rhinitis or hay fever, which has a conjunctival component and results in red, watery and itchy eyes. The cardiovascular system also has an impact on our eyes. Yes, our eyes are richly supplied by blood vessels that keep the structures nourished. Hypertension or high blood pressure and stroke have serious vision and ocular complications. We have often heard and observed the term hypertensive retinopathy in relation to it. Carotid artery disease is also a common cause of transient ischemic attack or TIAs, which is a stroke that lasts for a few minutes when the blood supply of a particular part of the brain is briefly blocked and has associated visual symptoms of blurring or loss of vision. Marfan syndrome is another hereditary anomaly which has cardiac signs and symptoms and also an ocular component where we see a subluxated or dislocated lens, which occurs as a result of abnormal growth of the lens zonules that hold the lens in place. Now let's look at the endocrine system, which is a chemical messenger system comprising of feedback loops of the hormones released by internal glands of an organism directly into the circulatory system, which regulates distant target organs. The major glands of the endocrine system include the pineal gland, pituitary gland, pancreas, ovaries, testes, thyroid glands, parathyroid gland, hypothalamus and adrenal glands. The most obvious potential problems involving this system is diabetes mellitus and its complications related to the eye. It is important, however, to mention another condition named thyrotoxicosis, which is an increase in the secretion of the thyroid hormone. It can produce devastating visual complications, including blindness. Graves' disease is another condition that can cause ocular signs. It is an autoimmune disorder that causes hyperthyroidism or an active thyroid. With this disease, your immune system attacks the thyroid and causes it to make more thyroid hormone than your body needs. Certain signs of it in the eye are seen in the form of conjunctival hyperemia, an excess of blood in the vessels of the conjunctiva, and mild proptosis or outward bulging of the eyes. These can lead to blindness that progresses in a relatively rapid order, from vision problems due to compression of the optic nerve to complete blindness. Let's look at the dermatological system. The eyelids and lashes are often the place where more diffused kind of dermatological diseases show. A good example is atopic dermatitis or eczema, which can show in the palpebral conjunctiva, which is a clear membrane that coats the inside of the eyelids. The eye care practitioner should take a careful history in order to reach a better diagnosis. The gastrointestinal system. Not many diseases affect the gastrointestinal tract and the eyes simultaneously, but there are a few. The Hermansky-Pudlak syndrome is an extremely rare autosomal recessive disorder and a hereditary condition which has gastrointestinal symptoms like bleeding problems due to a platelet abnormality, and also shows itself in the eyes, typically in the form of ocular albinism, which is a decreased pigmentation in the various structures of the eye. There is also increasing evidence that diet and ocular conditions may be linked. Gyrate atrophy of the choroid and retina is a good example, which is an inherited disorder of protein metabolism characterized by progressive vision loss. There are certain conditions of the genitourinary system that can cause an impact in our eyes. Reiter's syndrome is a condition of young males with sterile inflammation of the urethra, arthritis and conjunctivitis as the ocular involvement. A history of sexually transmitted disease should place the clinician on an alert for ocular problems. The ocular problems that the practitioner must look for are interstitial keratitis in patients with syphilis, iritis in those with disseminated gonorrhea, or cytomegalovirus retinitis in patients with AIDS. Also, the eye care practitioner should be highly suspicious of other forms of sexually transmitted disease when faced with a diagnosis of a particular sexually transmitted disease. There could be conditions related to the psychiatric system as well that can impact the eye. The first condition that the practitioner might enlist is hysterical reaction, with tunnel vision as its classic symptom. Hysterical reaction or hysterical conversion disorders are unexplained neurological deficiencies as a result of psychogenic stress or emotional conflicts. It includes vision loss. Patients can have hysterical amblyopia, that is an apparent reduction of vision in one eye without any lesion or injury. This, however, is not the most common form of psychogenic visual problems. Rather, the eye care practitioner must look out for stress-related illnesses that are the most common form of conditions resulting in problems in our eyes. The eye care practitioner should be alert towards this because it can save considerable time, cost to the patient, and frustration relating from inability to identify any functional disorder early on during the patient's workup. For example, the spouses of practitioners commonly have conditions that are related to the type of practice of their spouse. An example of an imaginary case is the wife of an optometrist who noted a source of light appearing as wavy to the temporal side of vision in her right eye during the week preceding Diwali. She complained that this has been present for about a week and that if she shut her left eye, she would lose the right three lanes of the highway. She underwent a workup with the appropriate ocular and neurological evaluations and was found to have an enlarged blind spot. All other test results were within normal limits. The symptoms continued without any reduction in intensity or strength till end of December and then disappeared. The symptoms reappeared during the months of March to June of the following year, but this time they disappeared much sooner. Things were relatively normal until Diwali of that year, when the scotoma and wavy light reappeared and remained until the end of the year. It was then that the pattern became evident. When the spouse was to visit her mother-in-law, the condition would increase, only to resolve after the stressful situation had passed. A more critical situation would be a patient who feels the urge or need towards self-enucleation with his hands. For my viewers, let me tell you what enucleation is. It is the removal of the eye that leaves the muscles and the remaining contents of the eyeball intact. Yes, it can happen and is normally caused by psychosis, paranoid delusions or drugs. The patient might eventually be successful with one eye and come close with the other. This is not a common problem, but it is one that eye care practitioners might learn of during the taking of the case history and when assisting a psychiatrist with the management of a patient. These were some of the ocular impacts that various conditions in our body can cause. The human body is a beautiful example of an interconnected and interdependent whole. We hope that you continue exploring the correlation between the various systems in our body and hope this video helped you on your quest. Do let us know your thoughts and queries in the comment section below. Also, feel free to let us know of any ocular manifestations of conditions that you come across.